How'd you like the highlight, Jake? What are you laughing at? That's the best I had. I brought the blooper tape. We've been here all morning. How'd you like Vince Scully calling that first at bat? At 6'3", 210 pounds, he made an impressive looking gentleman. Things change, young men. Do we have any Royals fans here?
Yeah!
All right! Wow, that's called perseverance. Any Mets fans? Dude, you're my man, all right. Good job. What do we got here? Cubs fans? Any Cubs fans?
Yeah.
Cubs fans? Wow. This is a World Series race, you guys. That's what this looks like. Enough boasting about our teams and things of that nature. Let's get right down to what we came here to boast about today, and that's our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Because that's what it's all about. It's not about a World Series trophy and championships and the ring, because all those things will one day come to pass. And I don't want you to think that I'm up here because of that stuff. It says, let not the wise man boast of his wisdom. Let not the strong man boast of his strength. Let not the rich man boast of his riches. But let those who boast of this, that I am the Lord, Lord God Almighty. That's what we're here today about. Nothing more than that. That's the bottom line. And I, just in case there's any attorneys in here today, I want to share with you my personal disclaimer. You see, I'm just a sinner, saved by the blood of Jesus Christ on the cross. That's it. When Paul wrote my disclaimer, he said, no, dear brothers, I am not all that I should be. But I'm bringing all my energies to bear this one thing, forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead. Find your children's passion, and then find those of faith that are involved in that passion. For me, I want to be an NFL quarterback, or I want to be a big league baseball player. And so my parents, in their tremendous wisdom, gave me required reading. But it was fun stuff. It wasn't like, you know, big old thick Jonah and the Whale or whatever those big books are. I've never read any of those anyway, so I don't know what they are. But they gave me Fellowship Christian Athlete magazines. So it was about guys that had a passion for Christ, but they had sports. And so I just grabbed on and, oh, baseball, football, yeah. And I'm reading about Tom Landry, all these big guys, and I'm getting fed. And like some of the young people here today, my parents would give me the opportunity to come and hear guys like Jake and Troy, Coach, hear them share their faith. And I would sit in these very chairs and I would look up and, wow, if God would only allow me to be a big leaguer or an NFL quarterback. About ninth grade though, things changed. We went from a certain denominational church to a Southern Baptist church. Got any Southern Baptist here?
Amen.
Amen. Let me ask you this question. Does your pastor, at about 5 till 12, maybe 10 till 12 if you're lucky, does his face start to turn red? Sweat boil up on his face? Veins and things bulging out? Does he do that? And then does he say, if you don't get down on your knees, you're going to die and we're going to go to hell? Boom! Like lightning bolt. Boom! 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 And he was always booming at me. And that part about going burning in hell got to me because Florida's hot. And I didn't want no more of that action. So it wasn't long there at that Southern Baptist church. I got up out. I can't get out. I got on my knees and said, Lord God. And I accepted Christ as my Savior. I came back down the next week just to make sure it took the first time. It's So I was a Christian. As a freshman in high school. But I don't know, maybe some of you might relate to what happened next. You see, I took God and I put him in my back pocket. Because I was off pursuing other gods. You know, I didn't leave God in my pocket all the time. You probably don't either, some of you. When you're facing Nolan Ryan and you haven't hit in 3 weeks.
Now I am led to be a living demonstration.
demonstration of Christ's power instead of showing off my own abilities. For when I am weak, then I am strong. The less I have, the more I depend upon Him. It's tough here in America today. We're struggling as a country. People are hurting. It's tough to buy that loaf of bread to some people. It's tough to fill that tank of gas. But God's grace is sufficient. But it just seems like, what is up? Are they doing what you want me to do? Maybe you're facing some of life's curves. Today I want you to know that His grace is sufficient. Can we bow our heads in prayer? Oh, our Father, it's so wonderful.